Let's get some practice solving some equations. And we're going to set up some equations that are a little bit hairier than normal. They're going to have some decimals and fractions in them. So let's say I had the equation 1.2 times c is equal to 0.6. So what do I have to multiply times 1.2 to get 0.6? And it might not jump out immediately in your brain, but lucky for us, we can think about this a little bit methodically. So one thing I like to do is say, okay, I already have the c on the left-hand side, and I'm just multiplying it by 1.2. It'd be great if this just said c, if this just said c instead of 1.2c. So what could I do there? Well, I could just divide by 1.2, but as we've seen multiple times, you can't just do that to the left-hand side. That would change, you no longer could say that this is equal to that if you only operate on one side. So you have to divide by 1.2 on both sides. So on your left-hand side, 1.2c divided by 1.2, well, that's just going to be c. You're going to be left with c. And you're going to have c is equal to 0.6 over 1.2. Now, what is that equal to? And there's a bunch of ways you can approach it. The way I like to do it is, well, let's just get rid of the decimals. Let's multiply the numerator and the denominator by a large enough number so that the decimals go away. So what happens if we multiply the numerator and the denominator by, let's see, if we multiply them by 10, you're gonna have 6 in the numerator and a 12 in the denominator. Actually, let's do that. So let's multiply the numerator and the denominator by 10. So once again, this is the same thing as multiplying by 10 over 10. It's not changing the value of the fraction. So 0.6 times 10 is 6, and 1.2 times 10 is 12. So it's equal to 6/12. And if we want, we can write that in a little bit of a simpler way. We could rewrite that as to divide the numerator and denominator by 6, you get 1/2. So this is equal to 1/2. And if you look back at the original equation, 1.2 times 1/2, well, you could view this as 12/10. 12/10 times 1/2 is going to be equal to 6/10. So we can feel pretty good that c is equal to 1/2. Let's do another one. Let's say that we have 1/4 is equal to y/12. So how do we solve for y here? So we have a y on the right-hand side, and it's being divided by 12. Well, the best way I could think of getting rid of this 12 and just having a y on the right-hand side is by multiplying both sides by 12. Let me do that in yellow. So if I multiply the right-hand side by 12, I have to multiply the left-hand side by 12. And once again, why did I pick 12? Well, I wanted to multiply by some number that when I multiply it times y over 12, I'm just left with y. And so y times 12 divided by 12, well, that's just going to be 1. And then 12, and then you're on the left-hand side, you're going to have 12 times 1/4, which is 12/4. So you get 12/4 is equal to y. Or you could say y is equal to 12/4. Y is equal to, let me do that in that, just so you see what I'm doing. I'm just swapping the sides. It doesn't change what's being said. Y is equal to 12/4. Now what is 12/4? Well, you could view this as 12 divided by 4, which is 3. Or you could view this as 12/4, which would be literally 3 wholes. So you could say this would be equal to 3. Y is equal to 3. And you could check that. 1/4 is equal to 3/12. So it all works out. That's the neat thing about equations. You can always check to see if you got the right answer. Let's do another one. Can't stop. 4.5 is equal to 0.5n. So like always, I have my n already on the right-hand side, but it's being multiplied by 0.5. It'd be great if it was just an n. So what can I do? Well, I can divide both sides. I can divide both sides by 0.5. Once again, if I do it to the right-hand side, I have to do it to the left-hand side. And why am I dividing by 0.5? So I'm just left with an n on the right-hand side. So this is going to be, so on the left-hand side, I have 4.5/0.5. I don't want to skip too many steps. 4.5/0.5 is equal to n, because you have 0.5 divided by 0.5. You're just left with an n over here. So what is n equal to? Well, 4.5 divided by 0.5. There's a couple of ways to view that. You could view this as 45/10 divided by 5/10, which would tell you, okay, well, that's just going to be 9. Or if that seems a little bit confusing or a little bit daunting, you could do what we did over here. We could multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number so that we get rid of the decimals. And in this case, you multiply by 10, you can move the decimal one to the right. So once again, it has to be multiplying the numerator and the denominator by the same thing. We're multiplying by 10 over 10, which is equivalent to 1, which tells us that we're not changing the value of this fraction. So let's see, this is going to be 45 over 5 is equal to n. And some of you might say, wait, hold on a second, Sal. You just told us that whatever we do to one side of an equation, we have to do to the other side of the equation. And here you are, you're just multiplying the left hand side of this equation by 10 over 10. Now remember, what is 10 over 10? 10 over 10 is just 1. Yes, if I wanted to, I could multiply the left hand side by 10 over 10, and I could multiply the right hand side by 10 over 10. But that's not going to change the value of the right hand side. I'm not actually changing the values of the two sides. I'm just trying to rewrite the left hand side by multiplying it by 1 in a kind of a creative way. But notice, n times 10 over 10, well, that's still going to just be n. So I'm not violating this principle of whatever I do to the left hand side, I do to the right hand side. You can always multiply one side by 1, and you can do that as many times as you want. Like the same way you could add 0 or subtract 0 from one side without necessarily having to show you're doing it to the other side, because it doesn't change the value. But anyway, you have n is equal to 45 over 5. Well, what's 45 over 5? Well, that's going to be 9. So we have 9 is equal to, why did I switch to green? We have 9 is equal to n, or we could say n is equal to 9, and you could check that. 4.5 is equal to 0.5 times 9. Yep, half of 9 is 4.5. Let's do one more, because once again, I can't stop. All right, and let me get some space here so we can keep the different problems apart that we had. So let's have a different variable now. Let's say we have g over 4 is equal to 3.2. Well, I want to get rid of this dividing by 4, so the easiest way I can think of doing that is multiplying both sides by 4. So I'm multiplying both sides by 4, and the whole reason is so because I have 4 divided by 4 gives me 1. So I'm going to have g is equal to, what's 3.2 times 4? Let's see, 3 times 4 is 12, and 2 tenths times 4 is 8 tenths. So it's going to be 12 and 8 tenths. G is going to be 12.8. And you can verify this is right. 12.8 divided by 4 is 3.2.